We want to determine the slope of the tangent lines at x equals 0 and x equals 1. So to do this, we'll have to determine the derivative function and then evaluate it at x equals 0 and x equals 1. And since the given function is a quotient of two differentiable functions, we'll need to apply the quotient rule to find the derivative, which is given here in red for reference. So we'll let the function in the numerator equal f and the function in the denominator equal g. So to determine f prime of x, we'll start with the denominator, which is just g squared, or the denominator squared. So we'll have the quantity x squared plus 1 squared. And for our numerator, we'll have g times f prime minus f times g prime, or the denominator times the derivative of the numerator, which would be negative 2, minus the numerator, which is negative 2x, times the derivative of the denominator, which would be 2x. So now we'll go ahead and simplify this and then evaluate this derivative function at 0 and 1. So here we'll distribute a negative 2, so we'll have negative 2x squared minus 2, and negative 2x times 2x is negative 4x squared. But since we're subtracting negative 4x squared, it becomes plus 4x squared. Now we'll combine the like terms in the numerator. So our denominator stays the same. So we'll have positive 2x squared minus 2. And there's a common factor of 2, and then this does factor. If we factor a 2 out, we'll have x squared minus 1. And then here we have a difference of squares. So we have 2 times x plus 1 times x minus 1 all over the quantity x squared plus 1 squared. So here's our derivative function. But our goal is to determine the slopes of the tangent lines at x equals 0 and x equals 1. So for f prime of 0, it'd probably be easier to evaluate the derivative in this form here. If x is 0, our numerator is negative 2, and our denominator would be 1 squared, or 1. So the slope of the tangent line at x equals 0 should be negative 2. We'll check that in just a minute. We also want to know the slope of the tangent line at x equals 1. So now we'll evaluate the derivative at x equals 1. And again, it doesn't matter which of these forms we use to evaluate this derivative, but looking at the factored form of our derivative, notice that if x is equal to 1, we have a factor of 0 in the numerator, and our denominator would be 1 plus 2 squared, or 4. Well, 0 over 4 is equal to 0. So at x equals 0, we should have a tangent line with slope of negative 2, and at x equals 1, we should have a tangent line with a slope of 0. Let's go ahead and check that graphically. Notice that x equals 0, the point is on the origin, and this blue tangent line does have a slope of negative 2. Notice from this point, we have to go down 2 units and right 1. And when x equals 1, that would be this point here, 1, negative 1. And we have a horizontal tangent line, which means the slope of this tangent line would be 0. So this does verify our work. I hope this example was helpful.